Cover crops, or green manures, have become a very important part of our low-cost and sustainable soil fertility program. In late summer, we plant a variety of cold-hardy legumes, along with cayuse oats. These crops fix nitrogen in the soil for future crops and provide organic matter for the soil. And the fixed nitrogen helps make it possible for us to get great results without having to purchase nitrogen fertilizers. Last weekend, we planted a mix consisting of 45% bell beans, 15% Biomaster peas, 10% each of Dundale peas, purple vetch, and cayuse oats, and 5% each of hairy vetch and common vetch. This is the same mix we planted last year with excellent results. The legumes in the mix fix nitrogen in the soil through a symbiotic relationship with certain soil bacteria. These bacteria have the unique ability to access nitrogen in the air and store it in nodules in the roots of the legumes. The nitrogen feeds the legumes, and the roots in turn provide nutrients to the bacteria. When the plants die, the nitrogen in the nodules is released into the soil and becomes available to other plants. Though these bacteria are naturally occurring in healthy soils, I did purchase an inoculant to ensure an abundance of bacteria for nitrogen fixation. Now that I've inoculated our cover crops 2 years in a row, however, I'm going to assume the bacteria are well established and won't purchase more inoculant in the future. To inoculate the cover crop, I mix some milk and molasses in a bowl and stir it in the inoculant. The milk and molasses serve as a food source for the bacteria. I then mixed in the seeds and started broadcasting them on garden beds where we weren't growing a fall crop. In some areas, we still had summer crops in the ground, so I just planted the cover crop around them. After broadcasting the seeds, I raked them in and covered them with a layer of compost, which is another important part of our fall garden bed preparation. I'll water the cover crops as needed, but chose not to water them at the time because the soil was still damp from the previous night's rainfall. Nitrogen-fixing cover crops need at least 2 months in the ground to fix nitrogen. Last year, all of them survived until nearly mid-December, so they should have plenty of time to work their magic before being killed by the cold. In fact, hairy vetch is cold-hardy enough to survive some winters here in Zone 5. But last winter's record cold killed all of the cover crops, including the hairy vetch. If they had survived the winter, I would have chopped and dropped them in early spring, before they went to seed, in order to incorporate their organic matter into the soil and prevent them from reseeding. Probably sometime in December, when the ground is covered with snow, I'll mulch the garden beds with leaves and use coffee grounds, which will provide a blanket of protection for the earthworms going into the coldest months of the year and a food source in the spring. Of course, the cover crops will become a part of this mulch layer as well, nourishing the soil and its many inhabitants. Well, that's all for now. Thank you very much for watching. And until next time, remember, you can change the world 1 yard at a time.